Hello friends, welcome to a new 3ds Max tutorial. This is Gökçe from CGCave.com and today we are going to learn about the soft selection in Edit Poly. Now that we are done with the sub-object modes, I'm going to create a new box. I will convert this to an Edit Poly and I'm going to show you some other properties in Edit Poly. And then after this lesson, we're going to look at Turbo Smooth, which is a very powerful tool. But we should know some basic things before we get into that. So let's increase the segments to 10 by 10 by 5. And let's set the dimensions to 80 by 80 by 20. And I'm going to move this box to the origin. If I hit F4, you will see that we have a bunch of vertices to work with. Now, if I assign an edit poly on top of this and hit 1, you will see that we are going to go to the vertex mode, and you will see that we have a tab called soft selection in here. Let's get rid of the other ones and just focus on this one. This sub-object or this tab also exists under other sub-objects, sub-object modes as well, like polygon mode, vertex mode, edge mode, border, even in element mode. So it exists in all of them. So let's hit 1 again, but I guess I usually prefer to edit or use this tab with the vertex mode. If I click on use soft selection and select a vertex, you will see that we have a circular mark or painting on the vertices. This is a weight, let's call it weight painting, because it paints the effect weight of the translation we are going to do. For example, if I move this vertex up, you will see that because this is red, it will be the one that is most affected. These will be less affected and the blue ones will be even less affected. If I move this up, you will see what I mean. If I move this up, you will see that the red vertex is the one that is affected most and the blue vertices are the ones affected least. So as you can see, if we use this tool, we can give or do slight modifications that affect more than one vertex, which is a faster way of working if you are going to create these type of organic models. I'm going to try to use this while creating a pillow. Of course, this is not the ultimate cloth tool. We do have a cloth modifier which is very, very nice, and I'm going to show that to you as well. But this will help us edit the final result after we use the cloth modifier. For now, we are going to just use it, but you will see what I mean in a minute. Let's check the parameters for now, and then I'm going to try to simulate a pillow, a cushion. I guess it's called a cushion. Okay. Now, the first thing I want to show you is, let's undo this, the last things we made. The first thing we can do is we can edit the falloff value. You can see that we can increase the area of effect with this value or decrease it. And other than that, we have the pinch value. You can check the graphic in here, which will help us understand how the shape will affect it. If I decrease the or increase the pinch value, you can see that we only have red and blue dots, which means that this mid vertex will be affected a lot while these will be affected little. You can also see the shape in here as well. Let me show that to you. You can see that we have a similar shape to this one. And if I decrease this pinch value, then it will create a shape like this. Let's try this as well. And then let's try to play with the bubble value, which will affect the sides of this vertex. You can see that we can create a circular shape like this. And these are the basic values you can play with while creating or while editing with soft selection. I know that there are a lot of different values, but I just want to show these basic properties and try to create something, because I don't want this to get boring. There are a lot of technical stuff. You can learn them as you need them. Right now, let's just try to create a cushion or pillow-like model. I'm going to increase the bubble a little bit. I'm going to add a turbo smooth on top, which will smooth the edges, as you can see. Okay. Let's add a new edit poly on top. Actually, let's delete this one. Yeah, sorry, add an edit poly. Let's hit 2 and select these two edge loops and click on under edit edges. We did have a command called create shape. And let's choose those splines and add a thickness to them. Now we can see that we have those pipes as well. And then we can just use this edit poly and attach the pipes to the model. Now we can hit 1 and use the soft selection. I'm going to increase the make it a little bit more bubbly. And now you can just select any of these and just give it a human touch. This is what we call human touch, because the pillow, in theory, the pillow will be seated on. It should have probably a small inwards bend in here. So we can just create that. I can also choose these edges and pop this a little bit. Maybe I can just decrease the falloff value. Okay. Just pull these out. Okay. As you can see, we have these this bump in here, maybe a little bit more, even a little bit more. As you can see, you can select multiple vertices with this, and it also works that way as well. Maybe we can just do this for all the sides. And as I play with the model, you can see that it slowly started looking more organic, more like a pillow rather than a 3D model, I guess. Let's check of the final result. You can see that this would even pass as a pillow. It's not a puffy pillow, of course, but I guess I could make this look realistic with some textures and some good lighting, I guess. But let's play with this even a little bit more. Okay, I'm basically, what I'm doing is basically I'm trying to add details in a physical way. I'm trying to think what happens to a pillow if someone sits in the middle. Probably this middle side will be bent down a little bit, and the other sides will be puffed up, I guess, right? So I'm just trying to imitate that, because the pillow will try to keep its volume the same. Of course, there will be some air leaking, so it won't exactly stay the same, but it will try to at least keep its volume. So I'm trying to imitate that. And in just a couple of minutes, you can see that we have a more organic looking shape than before. And I can just add another turbo smooth. This is I know this is too much vertices for one pillow. Actually, it's not that much. Okay, whatever. If I hit 7, by the way, you can see how many polygons we used. We used 28,000 polygons, which is too much for a game model, but this is not too much for a realistic rendering, architectural rendering scene, so it will work. Okay, as you can see, you can use soft selection to create these type of organic models. Okay, I hope this was useful. If you find it useful and if you found it fun, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button. Thanks for listening. See you in the next lesson.